Hello everyone, this is Zilzin Ziltor, and we're back completing the Archer quests. We're gonna try to get through as much stuff as we can today. I have all day, so. This next portion is gonna be a lot of cutscenes. So, last time we left off, we solved the case of the mysterious man, and now, Gridani is going to show us how grateful they are for being a hero. So now we're going to get the praise from the Elder Seedseer. So, I think with this one we have to go find a mask. Or get a mask. So we have to go consult the mother. And there's the dickweed. Go consult. And it's raining in Gridania. Ooh, rain. Okay, so let's see what she wants us to do. Alright, so I've been dubbed the Emissary. Emissary. I can't ever talk, can I? Aw, she was gonna bake me a pie. Alright, so the Green Bliss is an age-old ceremony for strengthening the bond between man and elemental. These days, though, the name also refers to the festival at large. In this ceremony, the Emissary serves as a conduit, a bridge between the people and the guardians of the Twelve's Wood. Suffice it to say, it is no small responsibility, nor does the Elder Seedseer choose mankind's representative on a whim. Seldom in history have non-firstborn been chosen for the role, which should give you of an idea of the magnitude of the honor being accorded you. For your part, you are required to wear a ceremonial artifact, which is presently in keeping of Timbermaster Beaton. Go to the Carpenter's Guild and collect it from the man, then return to me for further instructions. Alright, I'm going to tinker with my sound settings real quick because I can barely hear anything in the game. So I will be right back. Okay, so now we got to go to the Carpenter's Guild and talk to Mr. Beaton. Carpenter's Guild actually is not that far from where we are. So I was going to have a whole bunch of popcorn ready for this because this is going to be a lot of cutscenes. But I ended up eating the bowl of popcorn that I had ready, so not like you want to hear me munching on popcorn anyway, but I still have my coffee with whipped cream, because coffee with whipped cream is amazing, and not like the Cool Whip that you get in the freezer section. Go to your grocery store, and if your grocery store has a bakery, ask the bakery for their whipped cream. It is the best whipped cream ever. Fresh whipped cream from the bakery. I use it for cheesecakes, and it makes a hell of a lot of difference. And it's so much, and it's cheap too compared to the Cool Whip. So cheap. And so yummy. So you are the emissary to be. The mother sent word that you would be coming to collect the ceremonial artifact. The good news is that it's ready, painstakingly crafted by these very hands and from the rarest of materials. I'm sure it's very rare. Take it along with this warning. Get so much as a scratch on the thing and I shall make an unceremonial artifact out of you. That's nice. Isn't that nice? So I use the whipped cream from the bakery. I use it in coffee. I use it for hot cocoa, cheesecakes. It is just, and strawberries, if you ever want whipped cream and strawberries. So it's really great for strawberry shortcakes. So yum. And the grocery store that I go to, they even have the chocolate whipped cream too, which I use for my Death by Chocolate cheesecake. Back from your trip to the Carpenter's Guild, like, we had to go far. Let's see what you have in that box. What's in the box? Who knows? This is by far the finest mask I've ever laid eyes upon. The Timbermaster has truly outdone himself this time. In case he didn't mention, the mask is crafted from consecrated lumber rendered up by the Guardian Tree solely for use in the ceremony. In other words, it is priceless. Mother bids you to handle it with care. And with that, your preparations are complete. The venue should just take about. There should just be an order as well. If you have any questions, now's time to ask them. No questions. So that's the mask that we gotta wear. Let's see. Now that you have the mask, all that's left is to participate in the ceremony. Perchance you are feeling nervous, but never fear. Despite all the pomp surrounding the role, there really is nothing to being emissary. All you were required to do was wear the mask, stand up straight, and look dignified. The more involved aspects of the proceedings will be handled by the others. Simple, no? Your ceremony will be held at Miketo's Amphitheater. When you are ready, make yourself known to the caretaker there. Yeah. We had to clean that place up. And be sure to wear your mask or she may not recognize you. So now we gotta go to the amphitheater. So my goal for today is to get through all these boring cutscenes and then unlock the first three dungeons and maybe Palace of the Dead. Maybe. Alright. Amphitheater. Oh, while I'm here, I can check my mail. Okay, so now we gotta put our mask on. So we will look creepy. Super creepy. Let's see what we look like with the creepy mask. Look like one of those faceless creepy dolls. Oh, there she is. Yes, I am the emissary. And I have come prepared. I have my mask. Woo woo!
Look! The Elder Seedseer.
Yay, look at me. Oh god, imagine this cutscene with me wearing that BDSM gear I was wearing before I got this set. It'd be hilarious.
May she find favor with the elementals.
Sparkly! There's Papalimo and Ida. My boob just glowed.
This radiance. Could it be a crystal of light?
Could it?
Tell me true. Has the Mother Crystal revealed herself to you? Did you bask in her light?
And see, what kills me is they're all just now figuring this out.
Have you, perchance, experienced sensations akin to ether sickness of late? That Heidelin would speak directly to this woman. There once were dauntless adventurers who fought in the name of Eorzea.
And here we go.
When the primals threatened to bleed the land dry, these brave men and women rose to face them. When the Garlean Empire resumed its war of conquest, they rushed to the realm's defense. And when it was foretold that Dalamud would fall, they fought with all their strength to deliver us from certain doom.
Doom!
Yet as strong and as brave as they were, they, like so many, disappeared amidst the flames at Cartano. None have forgotten the heroes who gave all for the sake of a realm not their own. Yet when we try to recall their names, we find the pages of our memories are blank, as if bleached by the sun. And when we try to recall their faces, we see them only in silhouette, as if they stood betwixt us and a blinding glare.
Maybe they should all get their memories checked.
Hence have these heroes come to be known as the Warriors of Light.
And yet all forgotten. It's because everyone that was created got erased.
Beholding you, illuminated by the glow of the crystal, I could not help but be reminded of them. The crystal has chosen you for a purpose. Trust to its guiding light, and all shall be revealed to you in good time. Though none can say for certain what the future will bring, it is my belief that you may yet play a telling role in the tale of this great realm. For the power of the Echo resides within you.
And here comes the flashbacks. And my creepy little mask. And this is why I wanted popcorn.
Flames to the fore! Victory belongs to the bold. Show those Imperial whore sons what we're made of!
The left flank buckles. Divert the barracudas. Bid them hold that position, though it cost them their lives.
The yellow serpents are in need of succor. Pray, send the white wolves to their aid.
Will the white wolves have lollipops? You know, for their need to suck?
The adventurers risk life and limb for our cause. We must not fail them.
Oh, but you will. You will.
Is aught amiss?
This game has better facial expressions than Mass Effect Andromeda.
Bloody hells!
won't go down so easily. Eyes forward!
We are being watched.
Should have gotten some cookies.
Raging Bull, calling Bloodthorn. Bloodthorn, respond! Respond, damn you!
No, I think he'll respond when he's sleeping.
Raging Bull, what news?
We're surrounded by a blaze. There is no way out. God preserve, what is that thing?
What's going on? Speak to me!
God damn it! We cannot hold much longer!
Mad Snake! Mad Snake! Answer me! Damn it! Damn it all to the seventh hell!
I don't know why this is so funny to me.
Can they not be reached?
Sorry, Admiral. Shell's not working.
What of our own?
I cannot say, my lady. That monstrosity appears to be disrupting our communications.
We must keep trying. Call till they respond.
Yes, my lady.
Admiral, General, we can do no more. We must give the order to withdraw.
I will not forsake Louis Soir.
General, please. Victory may belong to the bold, but there will be no victor this day. You know this to be true. Let us not sacrifice lives in vain. The adventurers fight bravely, but to no avail. Let them withdraw, and let us be the ones to stand with Louis Soir.
Belay previous orders. All Maelstrom units are commanded to fall back, effective immediately.
What her outfit?
Give the foreign levy priority. Let the main host cover their retreat and bring up the rear.
Damn it. Relay the order. All flames are to withdraw. I don't care if our link cells are useless. You still have a working pair of legs, don't you? Well, use them, you bloody halfwit!
The outcome of this battle was long since decided.
You will all die.
Better to retreat now than risk a massacre. This dark, stifling presence. Who or what? We go to take our place beside Archon Louis Soir. To your positions.
Kasba Mool, Sogin Wese Tonzul. Lo Togalo. Asawad Deacon Bet Mubut. Imarat Way. Kiskat Togahat Wadadorns. Sees Nigen. Fizdun Nione Lamrai Zatai Dorn.
So this is what happens when the bad guys win. Now I'm in my inn room. Oh, I collapsed again. Go see the Seedseer. So I learned the other day that Final Fantasy XIV has lifted the time restrictions on trial accounts. So you can make a trial account and level everything up to 20. And before, you had 2 weeks. And so now apparently they took the time limit and you have indefinite. You could be a trial account forever. You just can't ever get past level 20 at anything. So if you had a trial account before, now you can get back into it and continue what you were doing. Which I think is pretty cool. Unlimited time, being level 20 on everything. Let's look at this person. Advent Cloud Strife. Not sure if cloud-like or not. Cloud on Mobius looks kind of wonky. Oh, there's the guy. And more cutscenes! As soon as I get over there. Surrounded by lancers. Yep, totally well recovered. Yay, let's see. Blah blah favor. I want you to go everywhere for me, like everybody else. Not like I have a choice. Gotta listen to your drivel, along with everybody else's drivel. So, I've written a letter to my counterparts in the Eorzean Alliance. Take letter. Oh, I still have that stupid mask on. The Battle of Cartanu and the calamity that followed claimed countless souls, of countless more bereft and alone. In the dark days that followed, many were the survivors who thought themselves less fortunate than the dead. 5 years have come and gone, but the land and the people still bear the wounds of the devastation. Nor are we any closer to learning the fate of the Warriors of Light. I'm too sober for this. Yet, so long as we live, never must we give up hope. We owe this to those who laid down their lives that we might behold another dawn. Aww. In remembrance of them, a memorial service will be soon held upon the anniversary of the Battle of Cartanu. This missive bears the details of that service. He graciously accepted the part of emissary in the recent ceremony. In other words, you accepted the offer to be my bitch. Should you be so willing, I would now make you my envoy and have you bear my message to our allies. Your dedication to the people of Gridania rouses fond memories in me, and I would choose no other for the role. Will you do me this favor? Well, it's not like I have a choice in the matter. I have to say yes, or else we get nowhere. Humbly, I thank you. Yeah, I'm sure you do. As you are no doubt aware, our partners in the Azorian Alliance lie some considerable distance away. Nor Ulda and Limsa Lominsa close to one another. Well, no shit. Yet fear not, for I have no intention of subjecting you, mine own newly anointed envoy, to a journey which would take weeks by land. Yay, airship. Woo. Airship pass. Yay. Yeah, I know where the airship landing is. Yep, yep, yep. This is no importance to anything pertaining to the storyline. Just like, now you are so privileged to be able to take an airship everywhere. Yeah, I'm awesome. We know this. By the power vested in me, I bid you journey forth as my envoy into the great realm of Eorzea. So, am I marrying the airship now? Walk her fields, bathe her seeds, and strive to know her better. Blah, blah, blah. Can we just get on with this? Why do you have to talk everything to death? Alright, before I go anywhere, I need to change my helmet out. What was I wearing? This. So I gotta go speak to the... Ugh. Gosh, they're gonna really drag this out, aren't they? So now we're gonna listen to Mother Mayon talk for like 20 minutes about how she's so proud of us that we made something of ourselves from this lowly slave to now an envoy, emissary and envoy. How she always knew we had greatness in ourselves, and she's so proud to know me. Yada, yada, yada. I mean, I love this game and all, but you'd think they would just cut to the bullshit already. But in true Final Fantasy fashion, they gotta talk everything to death. Yes, I went to go see the Elder Seedseer. That is so hard for me to say. Yes, I'm now the personal envoy. Yay. I'm the message lady. Yep, bear the missive. Yep, made a great impression. Yep, totally earned it with this tireless hard work because, you know, doing everyone's chores was so fulfilling. Yep. Of course you're proud of me. I love how she wants to take credit for everything that I've done. Yep. Eorzea is a big place, and now we have an airship pass. Yep, yep, yep. Lesser trodden region. Let's see, the clan rechanged the face of Eorzea, and how much of her now lies in the shadow beyond man's ken. It's a veritable playground for a wide-eyed adventurer like your good self. Yay. Can you just shut up so we can go? Yes, I know it won't be all fun and games. Yes, I know everyone has their own problems. I just want to go now. Yes, I will pull through because I'm awesome. Yep, 5 years. As everyone keeps saying, over and over and over. Okay, so... The airship person is on the other damn side. All the way down here. Let's see what hellhole they're gonna take us to first. Limsa Lominsa. I'm gonna walk up the gangplank. I love how everything is such like a huge production with me leaving. Yay, leaving. Oh, look like she's gonna cry. Oh, look at her. Oh, farewell, Tera. Like, I'm not coming back? I mean, you're just sending me to deliver fucking mail. One day, minstrels will sing of your deeds. Or maybe I will sing of my own deeds because I'm gonna be a bard. You wanna, like, throw flower petals up at me too? In the past or something?
It has been 15 years, but the bitter taste of defeat lingers still. 15 years since the Imperial fleet set course for Mordona, led by the Agrios, mightiest of all vessels. Silver Till Lake lay ripe for the taking, and all of Eorzea would soon be ours. Or so we believed. But an innumerable host of dragons met us that day, at the heart of which flew the great meat guard Zormer. Though we succeeded in slaying that lord among worms, the Dread Serpent's defeat was bought at too high a price. Our invincible flagship was lost, and all hope of victory with her. So ended our glorious conquest.
That was cool.
Eorzea, a blighted realm, riddled with false gods. Twice now, it has eluded the Empire's grasp. For all the destruction it wrought, even Meteor, the great sin, failed to yield us control over it. And for this failure, the realm has sunk deeper into depravity. It is twisted beyond all reckoning, rotten nigh to the core. Yet it must be saved. Only Garlean rule can bring order to Eorzea. It falls to us to deliver the misguided masses from their ignorance.
We're of one mind, Lord Vandalza.
The Hive Mind.
Senior engineers, please report to Magitek Research following scheduled inspection.
Is the Legatus really planning to take another tilt at Eorzea?
Apparently.
Hey, what hole have you been hiding in? We're in the midst of preparing for a new campaign, and a huge one at that.
But I thought the Emperor had given up the Western lands for lost after Cartano. What could the Legatus possibly hope to gain by acting alone?
I sense you harbor certain doubts over the wisdom of the Legatus's plan.
I love this guy.
My lord!
Please call me Nero. Tell me, where were you born?
Othard, my lord.
Alamigo, my lord.
Ah, codename Hummingway, I presume.
Kind of reminds me of, like, Billy Idol.
I don't know what you...
Or Spike from Buffy. Why not both?
Silence. Your denials will not change your fate. I assure you, Frumentarium sees all.
One-shotted.
Clean up this mess, and do not miss any, or I shall be most displeased.
At once, my lord.
Garland, soon you will be made to know the true power of Magitek.
And look where I have arrived. Where am I going? Either way. So before I do or meet with Merweb or whatever, or you pronounce her name, I'm gonna go around the city and collect all the aetherites. Teleports. Because that's just what you do when you get to a new city. So we're just gonna zippity doo dah everywhere. Did I miss one? I don't think I did. Oh, there it is. So. Here is a fun fact for you guys. So right next to the Arcanist Guild is a fairy. That particular fairy takes you straight to Vesper Bay. So one of my guildies had mentioned that they knew a quicker way to get to Vesper Bay, because as it was, what I did was to get to Vesper Bay, I went to Horizon and took the Chocobo from Horizon to Vesper Bay. But apparently it's quicker to hop over here to the ferry to get to Vesper Bay. And I don't know why I'm walking all the way back when I could have just taken the teleporter. Oh well. Ah, Santa Claus. Now we're gonna go this way. Nope, kind of don't want to be a fisher. And I think I'm lost. Nope, not lost. Wouldn't surprise me if I did get lost, because I'm kind of not paying attention to where I'm going anyway. Now we gotta go up the upper decks. We're gonna go up here first to the Marauders Guild and then come back down. Always explore a new city. Where the hell am I? I feel like I'm missing something somewhere. Oops. Hey, when I do that. Passing you up. No, I got them all. Okay, so now we're gonna continue. We're gonna go meet the head honcho of Limsa Lominsa. And more cutscenes. Woo-woo!
Enter.
I thought I did.
I did not expect the Gridanian envoy to be an adventurer. It speaks highly of your character that the Elder Seedseer would choose an outsider to represent her nation's interests. This way. I bid you welcome. I am Melvib Blufisvin, Admiral of Limso Lominsa, and Commander of the Maelstrom.
That kind of sounds German.
Now, what news from the Black Shroud?
Yep, a memorial service. Yep, it's been 5 years. The Meteor Project. Is that like the Manhattan Project where you just go blow everything up? Like, got this. Blah blah blah. He intended to cleanse our realm by snatching the lesser moon, Dalamud, from the heavens and cast it down upon our head. Boobs. The Elder Primal Bahamut. He's the one that destroyed everything. Of course he would be. Probably because someone saved you? Yep, all the beastmen's fault. Blah, blah, blah. I wonder how long this is going to take, like 2 hours before we get into some action? Yep, yay. Well, yeah, there's only 3 cities, and if I came from Gridania and I'm going to you, then of course my last stop would be Ulda. Makes sense, right? Alrighty, so Ulda we go, and we gotta go to Ulda and collect all the shard things. And while we're there, we're gonna pick up Pugilist too, because we're gonna need that later to unlock Bard, plus Palace. Lots of Palace to be had. Last night did a Palace run with my OC mates. I think we, oh god, how far did we get? I think we did 2 sets of floors. We started at 110, Or not 110, 111. Okay. Damn it, Siri. Shut up. We start at floor 111. Beat that boss. Which I believe was the flower dude with the bees. So that's 120. So we got, we did 121 to 130. Which is the hydro guy. So yeah, I think now we're on floor 131. Those floors aren't too hard, just gotta pay attention to what you're doing. I joke that how since my aether pole, or my aether pole armor and arm is past 90, I think I'm at like 95, 99. I was gonna go turn it in for my astrology and kenna, which would have to force us starting back to level, the floor is 1. Alrighty, so to the strip club. Let's go gather the alright, there's two things here, Chamber of Rule, and then all the way to the Alchemist. And as much as I come in here, I always get turned around. Ulda is like a huge place. I think it's bigger than the other two cities. And that's where we have to go, but we're not going there. Alright, I'm gonna take a quick break because my tummy is grumbly and I'm craving some hands. So I will be right back.